Hello, my friends of Guattari Labs. This is the second part of the tutorial of the basic example. Now we are going to explore something about the output. Okay, we are going to explore something about the output of Modflow MT3D, and then what we are going to do is to create more layers. Okay, let's go to the output model, output control, and then we have MT3D. And then I don't want that it will be at the end of simulation, but I want that the result will be at every 100 iterations, for example. Okay, that's right. And then what I want is more this, like more resolution of my contaminant plume. So for that, I'm going to take layers, and then we are going to have it in 6, or like in 5. No, in 6 is okay. And then data delete more results, and then we are going to run the flow model. Okay, the flow model is okay. Let's check if okay, it's injecting. Okay, actually it's only 1 liter. Wow, coming. And then what we are going to do is to we are going to run the MT3DMS. Okay, look, these are the iterations. So for every iteration, for 100 iterations, it creates one output. Actually, it have like 16 outputs. Maybe I should have set up this to, because it's a lot. I mean, it's a lot of outputs, and maybe this might be very hard to very it will be a big document. Okay, you see, this is the amount of that was injected, this is the amount that went, and this is how what stays on the system. Okay, so and then if we apply this, now we are going to have every iteration, and then like I can say there was 300, 3500, and I want to see the 500, I want to see the 1000, 1000, 250, the 2000. Okay, let's say that I want the 1000, 2000, 3000, and 3005. Okay. Okay, that's great. So now we can explore. Okay, what we are going to do is that we are going to explore. Okay, this is the first layer. Okay, we have two layer groups. Okay, this is the first layer, this is the second layer, this is the third layer, this is the fourth layer, this is the fifth layer. Okay, so our contaminant plume is like very geometrical. Okay. And then this is the resolution of your contaminant plume, okay, with depth, look, okay, but we can see this as well with time. So let's see, this is at the beginning at 1000 iterations. Do you see something very interesting here? Yeah, I know if you can see. This is a 100 iterations. And let's see at 200 iterations, 100 iterations. Yeah, this is 100 iterations. Let's show you the 200 iterations, 300 iterations, 400 iterations. No, once again. This is the 1000 iterations. And the main question is, does it change? Do you see that it changed? No, they do not change. Why? Because they have reached the steady state. Okay, so I mean, if I want to plot, I can plot maybe the 100 and the 300 iteration to see the contaminant plume like arriving to the boundary conditions. Okay. Okay, 100 iterations. Okay, this, okay, here the contaminant plume is going through the general head boundary. And this, on 400 iterations, it has already reached the general head boundary. And then look, on 1000 iterations, it has already reached the steady state on contaminant transport. Okay? And that's it. Okay. So what does it mean? Is that everything that goes to the beyond or like after the 100 iteration, the time related to the 1000 iteration, it will be the same on contaminant transport. Okay, so thank you for following us. Thank you for following this tutorial. Yeah, this tutorial is like very explicative of, and is a complement of the other tutorial. Okay, you have. I want to mention that you have the abilities to do some animations. Like you can do an animation of the concentrations. Okay, let's fix this. Okay. Okay. Okay, and this you can do the animation just by selecting the 3D data. You can do. Okay, you can do better animation. Yeah, once again. Yeah, with if you control better the time initialization, you can have like a better animation. Okay, so far this is the there are some tutorial, there are some, if you want to see as well, there is the there is one USGS model viewer. This is a software that is compatible with ModFlow MT3D. Yeah, this software allows you as well to see to create some visualization in 3D. And then on coming tutorials, what we are going to do is that we are going to have what we are going to do is that we are going to have another Python, I mean another visualization, because we want this to be we want this to be on Paraview as a BTK format, that is a That is a format that is awesome. Okay, so and creates good, creates excellent and awesome graphics. Okay, so thank you for following us. And my name is Hormontoya Montoya from Hatari Labs. I hope to see you in coming tutorials. Bye bye. Bye.